लास्ट डे वी हैव सीन क्लिपर सर्किट्स, नाउ दिस इज द क्लैंपर सर्किट. सो व्हाट इज दिस क्लैंपर सर्किट बेसिकली इज, सो इट इज बेसिकली अ डायोड नेटवर्क व्हिच यूज्ड टू क्लैंप. सो क्लैंपिंग मींस और टू पुल अप समथिंग. क्लैंपिंग मींस टू पुल अप समथिंग और टू फिक्स समथिंग टू अ सर्टेन लेवल. सो इट इज बेसिकली अ डायोड सर्किट यूज्ड टू क्लैंप एन इनपुट सिग्नल टू अ डिफरेंट डीसी लेवल. ओके, सो हाउ वी कैन डिफाइन, वी कैन से दैट इट इज अ डायोड सर्किट यूज्ड टू क्लैंप एन इनपुट सिग्नल टू अ डिफरेंट डीसी लेवल. Okay, or in other words, we can say a clamper circuit is used to add a DC voltage, or we can say a clamper circuit is used to add a DC voltage to its input. Or another way also we can define that a clamper circuit is a network which consists of a diode, a resistor and a capacitor that shifts a waveform to a different DC level without changing the appearance of the applied signal. A network constructed of or consisting of a diode, a resistor, and a capacitor that shifts a waveform to a different DC level. To a different DC level without changing the appearance of the applied signal. Okay, so our applied signal, it will remain same in the output, but it will simply shift to a different DC level, or we simply add some DC voltage with the existing input signal. So let us go with our first circuit, that is our positive clamper. So it consists of a diode, resistor and a capacitor. So capacitor is the main constituent of the clamper circuit. So this is our capacitor, this is the polarity of the capacitor, this is the diode being connected in the node A and B, this is our load resistance RL, and where we will collect this out, and this is the okay. So obviously as the diode is used, so we can say for certain reason this diode will be on, for certain reason this diode will be off. Okay, so when the diode will be on, this one will act as a short circuit, or if we have been considering a practical diode, it will have certain knee voltage and a forward resistance, and when it will be off, it will simply act as an open circuit. So let us consider the ideal case where it will act as in short circuit. Okay, and another case where it will act as an open circuit. So we need to find out when this diode will be on or short circuit, for which polarity of the input signal, or for which half of the input signal. So let us consider this is the input, end of input, which is having peak value is Vm. Minus Vm. Now, when we have been considering initially that our diode is discharged, there is no charge exist in the, sorry, not diode, the capacitor is discharged. There is no charge exist initially when we have been starting our operation. We have been assumed that. Okay. So, if we have been considering this diode is this capacitor is discharged, so for the positive half, initial positive half, this diode will be off because positive is connected with negative. Now when first negative cycle will come, the current will flow like this. For the when this diode is conducting, so we can assume that the current is flowing like this. The current is flowing like this. So when this diode will be off, the capacitor will not in the charging state. But when this polarity will come, that is the current is been flowing like this from anode to cathode, the capacitor starts charging. When this is the polarity of the input, that is for the first negative cycle, the diode will be on and current will flow like this. So this capacitor will start charging. So let us consider the maximum charge which can acquire this capacitor, that will be the Vm, that is maximum of the input. Maximum of the input will be applied across this capacitor. Right. So if this is the short circuit condition being taken for this diode, so this Vm, that is the Vi, maximum of Vi will be applied across this capacitor, and this capacitor will charge up to maximum of the Vm. Right. Now, next case, when another positive half will come, that is after this negative half, next this positive half will come. So for that case, the capacitor is charged. Now this capacitor has fully charged Vm. So when this one will come, that is positive half will come, that is minus plus minus plus. Okay. So this cumulative voltage will be now applied across this diode. The cumulative voltage will be applied across this diode. So when this one will come, that is minus plus, it is also minus plus, but which is charged to maximum. Now this cumulative voltage will be applied across this diode, so diode will be in the off state. So whole of this voltage will be coming across this RL. Just try to understand. Initial case, when this positive half will be there, so this positive half will make this diode off because this capacitor is discharged initially. Second case, when this first negative cycle will come, at that case the diode will be on. So when this diode will be on, so this current will flow through this capacitor. So capacitor will start charging. So it will charge up to maximum of the input, that is Vm. So when this first negative cycle came, that time the capacitor has charged. That time the capacitor has charged to its maximum, that is Vm. Now in second case, when this second positive half will come, the cumulative voltage will be applied across this diode, that will be minus plus plus minus, that is input Vm sin omega t plus this DC voltage Vm. One is, so we can say the voltage applied across this VAB, that will be Vm of this capacitor plus Vm sin omega t. That is the cumulative voltage applied across this diode. So diode will be in the off state for this case. Now second negative half when come, this second negative half, it is of the first negative half, this is the second negative half. So our Vm will be now negative. So what will be the case? That one will be for the second negative half, VAB will be Vm minus of Vm sin omega t. So for the maximum case, for when this sin omega t will be maximum, that is 1, the VAB will be given 0 voltage. So at this position across the node A and B, the voltage applied is 0. So you will find that maximum voltage can be given at this node A and B, that will be twice of Vm, and minimum, that will be 0. So our initial input was ranging from Vm to minus Vm. Now our output will be vary from twice Vm to 0. So our output now can be like this. So this will be the reference level, our 0 voltage. This will be Vm, and the peak will be our twice of Vm. That will be our output. Clear? So this is the shifting. This amount has been shifted. That is DC level shifting. This amount has shifted. Clear? Now, if we consider a practical diode is used, when a practical diode will be used, so there will be certain drop across this diode. So maximum charging can be allowed for this capacitor, that will be Vm minus V gamma. Vm minus V gamma. So the charging of this capacitor, that will be Vm minus V gamma when practical diode is used. For the practical diode, VAB will be Vm minus V gamma, that is the capacitor voltage, because this one will be negative, this one will be positive. So for the negative half, if it go like this, minus plus, plus minus, plus minus. So when we'll find the voltage across this VC, so that will be, that is minus plus, if we consider Vm, plus minus will be minus, plus minus will be minus. So VC will be Vm minus V gamma. So VC will be, the voltage across this capacitor will be Vm minus V gamma plus Vm sin omega t. So when this Vm will be positive, that will be twice Vm minus V gamma. When it will be negative, so that will be minus V gamma, right? For the positive half, when the capacitor has already charged, for the positive half, that will be Vm minus V gamma plus Vm. That will be twice Vm minus V gamma. Maximum of VAV, that will be Vm minus V gamma plus Vm. That will be twice Vm minus V gamma. And minimum of VAB when negative half will come, that is Vm minus V gamma minus Vm sin omega t. So if we consider omega t is 90,
we will have the maximum of Vm that will be coming out as minus of V gamma. So for the practical case, the variation will be starting from minus of V gamma. So this reference level, now it will be minus of V gamma, rather directly zero voltage, minus of V gamma. This one will be Vm minus V gamma, and the maximum will be our twice Vm minus V gamma. That will be our output. Clear? Any doubt on this? Anyone? Similarly, if we change the polarity of the capacitor as well as the diode, we can have the negative clamping as well. Anyone having any doubt? Yes? Practical diode. Okay. For this practical diode, okay, I'm just drawing another circuit for this practical diode. So I am just taking the consideration that our diode is on. So when this diode will be on, when this negative half will come, right? Up to this clear? When the diode will be on, that much is clear? Yes. So I am just taking that the negative half is applied, first negative half. This is the first, this is the second, this is the third. This is the first, second, third, right? So first negative half, when it will apply, our diode will be on. So when the diode will be on, it will have a voltage drop, right? It will have a voltage drop, that is knee voltage of V gamma. So let us represent the diode as a voltage drop of V gamma. So this is our capacitor. Capacitor, there will be a voltage drop. So voltage drop will be cathode, anode, right? Our RL, input is applied. Here input, the polarity will be the negative. So this one will be negative, this one will be positive, that is VI. It is our negative positive, it is our negative positive. That is our output, RL. So when we'll apply the KVL in this case, so let us consider the current along the direction like this, because now our current will flow from anode to cathode. So let us consider this is our V gamma. This is the voltage across VC. So we need to find out what is the voltage across this VC. So as this current is flowing like this, anti-clockwise direction, so minus plus, if we consider plus, so plus minus will be minus, plus minus will be minus. So VI minus V gamma minus VC is equals to zero when we have applied KVL, right? So our duty is to find out what is this VC. The VC is VI minus V gamma. So what is this VI? VI is Vm sin omega t minus V gamma. For the maximum of the input when it will be applied, that will coming out as Vm minus V gamma. That is our VC. Now, for the next positive half when we apply, let us consider. So, this is the case for the first negative half. Next case, when second positive half will be applied. Okay. Our diode will be there. So, I am just representing this diode by an off condition. Why I am just telling you? So second half, positive half means this one will be minus, this one will be plus. Input is applied. Now our capacitor has already acquired this much voltage. The capacitor already charged up to this much. That is your minus plus, but it has charged. Maximum voltage is Vm minus V gamma. So this is the voltage which is be applied across the diode. So what will be that voltage? We need to find. So why I have written that one as a off switch, because the capacitor has already charged. So our diode was connected like this. This part, it is the cathode, this is the anode. So cathode is connected with positive. So obviously diode will be in the off state. Diode will be in the off state because the capacitor is making this diode off. Now we need to find out what is the voltage applied across this node AB. So whatever the voltage applied across this node AB, the same voltage will be across this load. That is our V out. So now again applying KVL, this is plus, this is minus. So like this, current is flowing like this. So minus plus is taken as plus. Minus plus is taken as plus, that is Vm minus V gamma. Plus minus will be taken as minus. So that will be our V out. So let us find out what will be that V out. Vi will be Vm sin omega t minus, sorry, plus Vm minus V gamma. So for the maximum case, this V out, that is our VAB, that will be Vm plus Vm minus of V gamma. That will be twice Vm minus V gamma. Right? So this is the condition for the second positive half. Now come to the second negative half. When second negative half will come, let us check. So now onwards, from the first positive half onwards, that as the capacitor has charged, whatever the input is, either it is positive half or negative half, irrespective of that, the capacitor always making this diode off. The capacitor making the diode off, irrespective of whatever the input, either it is a positive half or either it is a negative half. So we need to first go up to the first positive half. First negative half. When first negative half is applied and it makes the capacitor charge to maximum, then whatever the half will be applied, either it is positive or negative, that diode will remain off. So when negative half, second negative half will be applied, the diode will be in the off state because the capacitor has already charged to its maximum. It is off. Now negative half is applied. This is our RL. This is the output plus minus V out. It has already charged to its maximum, that is Vm minus V gamma. Vm minus V gamma. So now again applying the KVL, the current is flowing like this. Minus plus is taken, if we have been taken as plus. So Vi minus plus plus V naught, then it is plus minus will be minus Vm minus V gamma is equals to zero. So we need to find out this V naught. V naught is VAB, that is Vi minus of Vm. Sorry, that one will be become minus. It will become plus Vm minus of V gamma. Right? So this Vi can be written as minus of Vm sin omega t plus Vm minus V gamma. So that one will be for the maximum case, minus Vm plus Vm minus of V gamma. So that one coming out as V gamma. So whatever the input we have been applying, the output will now vary from maximum to minimum. So what will be that maximum to minima? Minima will be our minus of V gamma. Maximum will be our twice Vm minus V gamma. So it will, now its reference value will be Vm minus V gamma. Vm minus V gamma. That will be our output. Clear? So we need to first find out for which half initially, because we have been considered our capacitor is discharged. When we have been connecting the capacitor, it is fully discharged. So first of all, we need to identify for which half our diode is on and making the capacitor to charge to its maximum. That is what we need to find out. When we have been taken the half that has been responsible for capacitor charging. After that, the diode will always remain off because the capacitor voltage is making the diode off. Clear? Now, as we have been taken this VAB will be the cumulative voltage of VI plus that VC, we must needs to ensure that our capacitor is not at all discharging through this RL. Capacitor may discharge through this RL because one load is connected. So to ensure this discharging to not happen, we need to take the time constant of the capacitor is much higher than the frequency of the input or the time period of the input signal. That is, the time constant of the capacitor for this case, that will be time constant, that is RLC, right? T will be RLC, the capacitor, this resistance and this capacitance, that is the time constant, right? That should be greater than the time period of the input signal. What is that time period? Time period is 2i pi by omega, that is our omega t, right? 2i pi by omega. So this time constant must be greater than. What does it mean? Time constant making greater means, let us consider within this time when this diode is off, somehow it tries to discharge. It tries to discharge. So what does it mean? Let us consider the current is flowing like this. So when it will take a chance for the current to discharge through this resistance, that time only our input will arrive. That time only our input will arrive. So let us consider the most obvious situation for this capacitor to discharge is the positive half. Is the positive half, because this positive half is making this diode off. So no current will flow through this diode. All the current will be flow through this resistor. So this capacitor may find a chance to discharge through this RL. So the time required for this capacitor to discharge, before discharging another input arrives. So that input, let us consider the negative half is the obvious reason for the capacitor to charge. So before that discharging time, before the capacitor starts discharging or just started, before that the input will arrive. That is, the time period for the input is quite lesser than the time period required to capacitor to discharge. So before that our input will arrive. So let us consider for this positive half, for this positive half, obviously the capacitor taken a chance to discharge. So it has start discharging. That moment it has starts discharging, negative half arrives, means it will again charge because this diode will be in the on state. If it is discharged, means somehow if this voltage is somehow this cathode voltage is not at all been appropriate for making this diode off, so diode will be on. So the moment the diode will be on, the capacitor will again start charging. So here the positive half, the capacitor starts discharging, that moment the negative half will apply, so capacitor will be again charged to maximum. Now this diode will be again off. So that is what we must need to ensure, that our time period should be much lesser than the time constant of the capacitor. Yes, any doubt? Anyone having any doubt? Next one is a negative clamper. So after that, I hope you will able to find out the output voltage for this any kind of clamping circuit. So for this case, the only change is the polarity of the capacitor and the diode. Sorry, not that one. It will be like this. Okay, so for this case, when the initially the capacitor is discharged, when this positive half will be applied, our diode will be in the on state. So our diode will be in the on state means capacitor starts charging. Once this capacitor has charged, fully charged, this capacitor will make this diode off, because the anode of the capacitor, anode of the diode is connected with the negative terminal of the capacitor. So the maximum voltage that can be charged it up to Vm. So this Vm will make this diode off. So for the first positive half, this diode will be in the on state and the capacitor will charge up to this maximum. After that, for every cycle, this diode will be off and the total voltage which will be applied across or been found across this output load, that will be Vi plus Vm sin omega t. Vi plus Vm sin omega t. Clear? So what will be this voltage? Let us consider it has already been charged to maximum. So for the positive half, this Vab will be minus plus plus minus plus minus. So if we take plus minus as plus, so plus minus minus plus, that is Vi, plus minus will be plus Vm. Vm means the voltage across this capacitor. So what will be this Vi? This one will be for the positive half, minus plus plus minus plus minus, right? Plus minus is taken as plus, so plus minus minus plus plus minus. So most probably it should be minus, right? It should be minus of let us apply this KVL. Vi minus Vc, then minus of V out, that is Vab equals to 0. So Vab will be Vi minus Vc, that is Vm, right? So Vi can be Vm sin omega t minus Vm, right? That will be our V output. So let us take the input, which is varying from minus Vm to plus Vm input. So when this positive half will applied, so our maximum now it will become zero for the positive half. For the negative half, it will be minus of 2 Vm. Just try to understand. When positive half will be applied, Vm minus Vm, it is zero. When negative half will be applied, that will be minus Vm, that is minus of 2 Vm. So the output for this case, it will vary from 0 to minus of 2 Vm V out. 0 to minus of 2 Vm. Clear? So how we have been found? We have taken that our capacitor has charged. So how it has charged? For the positive half, for the first positive half, for the first. So this output is after this positive half. Just try to understand. It is not at all for this positive half. It is after that. So don't take something like that. The moment we have applied our input, the output will be available. So that may be possible when we have connected a charged capacitor. That may be possible. That the moment we have been applied input, our output has been there. But when we have been considered that we need to charge our capacitor, so for this case, the output will be beyond this positive half. This output will be after this positive half. This may be possible when the capacitor has been connected, which is charged. So we have been considered that the capacitor has charged. How it is charged? When the positive half has been applied. So positive half has been applied, this diode is on, so current will flow through this capacitor and it has charged to its maximum. So when it will charge to its maximum, it will acquire a voltage of Vm. It has acquiring some charge which results into some voltage of Vm, maximum of the input. So when we have been applying the KVL, we have been found that Vab will be Vm sin omega t plus Vm. So let us check with the positive half and negative half. For the positive half, this one will be Vm maximum Vm. So Vm minus Vm is 0. For the negative half, that will be minus of Vm. So Vm minus Vm, it will be twice of Vm. So this DC level shifting occurs across the negative direction like this in the below. So that one will be minus Vm. Now this reference will become minus of Vm. Clear? Anyone having any doubt? We can also use some biasing voltage here also. Some biasing voltage will be applied, so there will be certain less much of shifting. Okay? If we have been applied certain biasing voltage, for the positive clamping as well as for the negative clamping, we can apply certain biasing voltage as well. So I am just giving a certain circuits, so you just go with that. Biased clamper. This biasing voltage is Vs. Okay, you just take this biasing voltage and try to find out the output. Same for the second case, second circuit. Just take this positive clamping along with the biased voltage. Biased voltage is like this. Out RL, this is your Vs, this is the input Vi. Third circuit, just take this one as now the polarity has changed. Circuit also has reverse polarity of the bias voltage. Some other circuits can be also possible by changing the polarity of the capacitor. For all of the four circuits, you just change the polarity of the capacitor and try to find out the output. Any doubt? Anyone?
Anyone having any doubt? Clear? Okay. So this is all about our diode circuits.